Second in the series, Understanding Nutrition, we'll examine the role of protein in the diet of the ruminant. Animals need three basic components in their feed for the maintenance of their body condition and for their growth and production. These are energy, protein, and vitamins and minerals. Proteins play both structural and functional roles in the bodies of all animals. Structural proteins include those found in skin, in muscle, cartilage, hair, and wool. Functional proteins include those such as enzymes and hormones. Enzymes are involved in all sorts of chemical reactions in the body, whilst hormones regulate processes such as growth and reproduction. Animal products such as meat, milk, and eggs contain proteins. Proteins are complex molecules made up of basic units called amino acids. Amino acids are made basically of the elements of nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen joined together. The amount of nitrogen in a protein can be measured by chemical means, and this forms the basis of the estimation of crude protein in feeds. There are 25 amino acids, which are found in various combinations of hundreds of units, make up the various animal proteins. How then can animals be provided with the protein that they need? In the first video in this series, we examined differences in the eating habits of various animals. And this was explained in terms of differences in their digestive systems. In the case of intensively managed animals such as pigs and poultry, specific information on their requirements for total protein as well as individual amino acids is available. Therefore, the protein requirements of different classes of these animals can be met by specially formulated diets fed to them. Yeah. such precise information not available for grazing animals like cattle, sheep. These animals have to gain their protein requirements from a wide range of feeds of different protein quality. Furthermore, they have to accept some modification of that protein quality through breakdown in the rumen by microbes. Let's now take a look at what happens to protein in the feed of sheep and cattle. We saw in the earlier program that ruminant animals like cattle and sheep have a large fermentation vat called a rumen in their digestive system. It is in the rumen of cattle and sheep that a large population of microorganisms, bacteria, single-cell organisms, and fungi start the fermentation process. The breakdown of the carbohydrates in the feed gives simple organic acids known as volatile fatty acids, which are absorbed and used in the animal as a source of energy. On the other hand, the breakdown of the protein component of the feed is a bit more complex. If the proteins in the feed are soluble, they are fermented in the rumen by the microorganisms in a manner similar to carbohydrates to give rise to amino acids and then ammonia. If the dietary proteins are not easily broken down in the rumen, they escape microbial action and pass through unchanged. When they reach the fourth stomach and small intestine, they are digested by the animal's own digestive enzymes into simple amino acids. These amino acids, in turn, are then absorbed and used as the building blocks by the animal for the manufacture of its own proteins. The breakdown and fermentation of feed protein in the rumen is in fact a process of degradation. The portion of dietary protein that is degraded in the rumen is therefore called rumen degradable protein, or RDP. And the portion that is not degraded in the rumen is called undegraded dietary protein, or UDP. This portion of dietary protein is also commonly referred to as bypass protein. Some of the feed protein remains undigested, and this is excreted in the manure and is thus unavailable to the animal. Depending on the extent to which proteins are broken down in the rumen, their degradability, proteins will supply different amounts of UDP to the animal. Good quality green pasture, for instance, contains a very high protein content, but as much as 70% of this is broken down in the rumen, with only 30% leaving as UDP, that is, as full chains of proteins. Protein sources such as fish meal, on the other hand, are of low rumen degradability and thus supply a large proportion of UDP compared to the highly degradable proteins of sunflower meal and peanut meal. Some feed proteins can be modified by treatment with heat or with a chemical such as formaldehyde so that their degradation in the rumen is restricted. Protein protected in this way is subjected to normal breakdown in the fourth stomach or abomasum, which is similar to our own stomach, and the small intestine. Examples of protected protein are heat-treated soybean and formaldehyde-treated sunflower meal. Certain methods of storage of conserved forage have also been shown to decrease the breakdown. The high dry matter content and the gentle fermentation of harvest or haylage appears to do this. A portion of ammonia released through breakdown of protein in the rumen is used as a source of nitrogen by the microorganisms in the rumen for the manufacture of their own body protein and for their own reproduction, using energy released through the fermentation of carbohydrates. Live and dead microorganisms in the rumen are constantly carried through to the rest of the digestive system, where their bodies are used by the animal as a protein source. The ruminant also has a means of conserving nitrogen, particularly during critical times of protein shortage in the feed, such as a drought, by recycling the urea in the blood into the rumen. either in saliva or by diffusion from the blood. In this way, the supply of nitrogen to the microorganisms is maintained even when the dietary supply is low. The recycled urea contributes to the ammonia pool in the rumen for microbial protein synthesis. The protein needs of a ruminant animal are therefore derived from two sources. One is the portion of the feed protein that reaches past the rumen undegraded, the bypass protein. And the other protein is derived from digestion of the microbial organisms, that is, microbial protein.
We have already seen that rumen microorganisms require a source of nitrogen, such as ammonia, for the synthesis of the microbial proteins. For normal rumen functioning, a vigorous microbial population is necessary. And as such, there needs to be a supply of ammonia and mineral elements such as sulfur to maintain normal rumen functions such as fermentation. However, it is not always essential that this ammonia be in the form of the breakdown of dietary protein. Indeed, rumen microorganisms can use ammonia from non-protein sources, such as urea and biurate.
These substances, collectively known as non-protein nitrogen, can be provided in the diet of a ruminant to meet some of the nitrogen requirements of microorganisms. It is indeed a cheap way of utilizing the rumen microbes to convert non-protein nitrogen sources like urea into higher quality animal protein through the synthesis of microbial protein.
It is often used in a drought as a supplement to very low quality grass, which otherwise would not be able to maintain the microbes in the rumen healthy.
Ruminants at a moderate level of production, such as mature cattle and cows in early pregnancy or late lactation, can be supplied with all of their protein requirements in the form of microbial protein from synthesis in the rumen. On the other hand, ruminants at a high level of production, such as growing cattle and cows in late pregnancy and early lactation, have a demand for protein that cannot be met only by microbial protein synthesized in the rumen. In these instances, extra protein needs to be supplied in the form of UDP or bypass protein, preferably in the diet.
Protein is a valuable component of feed, which however can easily be lost through grazing or conservation. The main ways in which it is lost are allowing the plant to go to head or to flower, for when the vegetative phase ends, protein levels drop off markedly.
And the drying of hay causes the leaves to become brittle and fragile, and this can result in large losses during raking or baling processes. In addition, the extended wilting time in windrows is responsible for a reduction in protein. Where air is able to penetrate silages, or hay made too wet without a quality preservative, the resulting bacterial activity gives off heat. Heat is a great destroyer of protein, breaking it down rapidly into its basic elements.
To overcome these problems, farmers should aim to cut and conserve excess forages and legumes before the heads or flowers emerge.
Having done this, the ideal way to conserve these forages is at medium moisture, between 40 and 50%, where overdrying is not required and leaf losses are minimized. This product is termed haylage R, but must be conserved in a harvestor system to avoid aeration during storage and feeding out. Haylage will not successfully compact to exclude the air in a pit or bunker, and excess heating would result if the farmer attempts to store it in a pit. Silage and hay must also be carefully made to avoid protein loss. Silage must be rolled and well sealed, and a suitable silage additive may be used to assist rapid preservation. To reduce leaf losses in hay associated with overdrying, a quality non-volatile hay preservative can be applied at baling to allow hay to be made at moisture levels up to 30%. This tape has shown that protein, like energy, is a very important component of animal feeds. For pigs and poultry, these proteins must supply particular amino acids to meet the specific needs of those animals. For ruminants, this is less critical because of the activities of rumen microorganisms. For ruminants then, protein can be classified into rumen-degradable proteins, or RDP, and undegradable dietary proteins, UDP, which are also called bypass proteins. It is important to realize that the utilization of both protein and energy must be considered together, for the effective utilization of one depends on the supply of the other, and possibly two, on minerals and trace elements. And that will be the topic of the third tape in this series.